there's a lot of interest in what do we do with our dogs when they reach the end of their working life. And there are many rumors and stories out there that dogs are left behind, and we have always had a commitment under the canine welfare umbrella and just an obligation to our canine partners to bring them back, to give them the best quality of life that we can give them after they're done working for us. So when we last talked and filmed, we were bringing back a plane load of dogs from Afghanistan, more dogs that were returning here to the U.S. And although we planned for the numbers to return, that large a number of dogs all at once presents a challenge administratively, logistically, and so fortunately for us, we have a great partner in Sarah Hare and Piper's Playhouse in Anniston, and she has done yeoman's work in getting these dogs matched up with families, doing the personality profiles and assessing the dogs to determine whether they're good with families or good with kids or other pets. We also then had a large number of dogs that were still had working life left that we continued to train. We've subsequently sent them to other contracts where they're working for us today. We've adopted well over half of those dogs coming back. There are only a couple left that need to find loving families. And the rest are, for the most part, back to work or prepared to go back to work. Those that were able to go back to work, we had one participate in the first ever canine biathlon up in Anniston, Alabama, as well at our training facility. So it was great to see the dog participate and see the joy that the handler had when he was able to use that dog and run this pretty arduous course that they had set up. It still gives me great pleasure to be able to come to work and say, I work with a canine company that does great things, keeping people safe, but also that we do great things for those dogs when they're done working for us.